In this video, we will create a second row of hamburgers, but we will cross them. So the first line, the first row will start with the bacon and the second row will start with the chicken burger to make it look a little bit different. So we start by going inside the main.dart and we will copy this hamburger list and paste it twice to another time. So we have twice of them. That means we will have two lists of hamburger. That's good. Next step that we will need to do. We will need to cross them. So to cross them, we will go inside hamburger list and we will create an input variable. That means the main file will send the data inside the hamburger list. To do so, we create the final int row, so an int variable. And this, we recall it by creating a constructor. And the constructor is just renaming the class name and putting bracket after. So we have built a constructor. Inside, we'll put curly bracket. And inside this one, we'll say this dot row. Only like that, we can send variable from the main inside the burger list. So this is input. Like example, if I write 1 and 2, the hamburger list will receive the 1 and 2 value. But to do so, we need to say the argument row 1 and row 2. So now we say row because the variable is called int row. That is why we need to do that. So now we have access to the row 1 or 2, depending on which one it is. So inside, so we have the container. What we will do next is using the row to reverse the value. So the reverse boolean is normally the index.even, but we will call the row by saying widget.row. So we have the value. So if the row is equal to 2, then this is good. We can say index.even, but if it's not 2, we say index.isOdd. That means if it's the first row, it will be the reverse. So as you can see, here we go. We have the burger bacon first. So that's good. And now we can do, we can change the name of the burger for sure for chicken burger or bacon burger. So we will use the reverse value. If it's true, the reverse, then we will say this is a chicken burger. And if the value is false, then it will be the bacon burger. Okay, so we have both of them. Now we will see the name change. That's good. That's very good. What else can we do? We will be able further then click on the button to navigate through another page. Maybe this will be nice. Or before that, what we will do is adding a little space for the second row. Because if you can see, if we come back inside the app, when we scroll down, we cannot see the second row like good. So we will need to add a little spacing. To do that, we can use the input that we have created, call it row. If we are in the second row, then put a little bit more space. Then if we are in the first row, that's it. So if we go inside the sliver to box adapter and the container, the height, we will say widget because we need to call, to say widget dot to call the row. If it is the row number 2, then put my, by example, 330. And if it's not, then 240. So now if we scroll down, as you can see, we can see the second row way more. That's very beautiful. Next step will be to click on the burger image and then be able to navigate through another page. That would be so much nice. So let's do that in this one. So what we'll do is when we click on the container or the burger, we will navigate through the other page. We will add this page right now. So I will close the image. And I will create a new file inside my lib. It will be called the burger.dart. Oh, burger page. Way better. Burger page.dart. And we import, as usual, the material.dart. So package. Then we say stateful widget. So stateful W. And we select this, not this one. We select the W. So I will remove the widget. And I will say control space to have the suggestion once again. And the stateful widget. We will call this class burger page. And we will remove the key. Then the container, we will replace it by a scaffold. So when we call this page, we will return a scaffold. So the build will return a scaffold. And in the scaffold, we have the argument app bar that will send, will return the app bar widget. Here we go. That's it. Last thing, we will need to give a name of this route. So we will say static const tag equal to burger page. That's mean when we the tag and the route is the same word for me. So when we say tag, it's the same thing as saying route. So when we go inside, not the pub spec, sorry, it is the main. We go inside the main and we need to call the route. So to tell which route are where. And when we call the route, this will let Flutter know, okay, I want to go inside this page now. So we will say route after the home argument. We use the route argument. And this, as you can see, it's a map of, oh, so if you go over, map of string and widget. So on the left, we have the string. On the right, we have the widget. So when we are calling the string, so the left, this will return us the right. So it will return what is on the right side. First, we need to import the burger page.dart. Good. After, if we go down and we find route, what we will say is burger page.tag. So when we call the tag, so the route, we want to return. So we put the return with the little bar under and we send the burger page. So when we call the name of the route, call it burger page, we return the burger page page. That's a lot of page. So you return the burger page like that. So let's start this. You need to restart the app to make the route remember. And then you can go inside hamburger list and replace the to-do navigator. You can replace it with a navigator.ofContext. And the after context, you will put .pushNamed. So that will push the page over this one. So we will pushNamed, use this one. And then we just need to put the name of the route. That's it. So we will import the page that we have created. So the burger page.dart. We import that. Here we go. And once we have import the burger page.dart, we can call the tag. So AKA the route name. So we click on it. We say burger page and dot tag. So this is the name of the route. So when we click on the button, so remember this gesture detector is the green container and not the burger image. So if you click on the burger image, it will not work. But if you click on the green container, it will work. So if you understand the burger.tag, this means it's only burger tag. It's the same thing. If you write burger page instead, it will be the same thing because if you go inside a burger page, you can see that the tag is equal to burger page. It's the same thing. So we will use the, so by example, if we go and click on the container green, you will go on the page anyway. So we will remove this one and write burger page tag because it's more conventional. And we will copy the navigator dot of context everything. And we will paste it at the end for the gesture detector of the image. So now when we will click on the image or on the green container, we will go through the page. So this is hot reload. And now when we click on the burger, we will go on the other page as well. So that's it for this one, and see you on the next video. Bye.